I hope you all are well, and today we will continue chapter 7. So today we'll study about that how we can create open save document in Writer. So Writer is actually what you see is what you get editor. Okay, so in short we used to write it like this, WYSIWYG. What you see is what you get. That means the way you are able to see it, the same way you will get the printout of it. Okay, so the screen shows exactly how your document will look when you print it out. So first of all, select the option file from the menu bar. Here you can see this is file menu. There will be a drop down. This is drop down menu, and from this menu you have to choose new option. When you'll click on new, you will get sub menu. This is sub menu. From here you have to choose text document. Otherwise you can also use the shortcut key Control N. Got it? So here let's see what is what you see is what you get editor. It is actually the program is the one that shows the document on the screen. Okay, with this you are able to see the formatted document on the screen, and it will look exactly same as you will get the printout. This is alternative. You can click here to create the document. Otherwise you can also choose the shortcut key Control N to create the document. Got it? The same way you can open the document also. The alternative is new document icon that is there in the standard toolbar, or press Control N shortcut key. So once you have got into your workspace, you can start typing or enter text you wish to enter. Got it? So as soon as you have created a document, new document, you will get the workspace over there, and then you can type the document to create a document. Now the text area. Text area, I have already told you earlier, it is area where you have to type. Okay, where you write, type the text is the text area. So there you will can observe the mouse pointer. Okay, the pointer becomes an I-beam when it is within the text area. You might have seen a blinking pointer over there on the mouse screen. Okay, it is blinking cursor. Okay, so it is known as the I-beam. When you move it outside the text area, it becomes an arrow. Got it? When you will click the mouse pointer in the workspace, it will become I-beam. Okay, and when you will click it outside the text area, then again it will become mouse pointer, word wrap, and the enter key. So on a typewriter, when you want to end a line, you know very well, when on typewriter you have to end the line, you have to hit the return key. And here in Writer, when a word does not fit on a line, it automatically flows to the beginning of the next line. Got it? That is word wrap. So without pressing the enter, you have seen when we are simply writing further, as soon as the space gets over, automatically the line starts from the new line. Okay, so however, you don't need to press enter. You are writing a short line, then you can press enter. Okay, if you don't want to reach to the right margin. So then if you want to end a paragraph, at that time you can press enter. When you want to create blank line, at that time you can press enter button. Got it? Non-printing characters. You can choose to have OpenOffice Writer display a number of special characters on the screen that shows the places in the text area where you press the space bar, the enter keys and tab keys. You might have seen that you do something with these keys like space bar, enter keys, tab keys. You know what are their uses, okay? But are you able to see these keys when you are using it on the workspace? No, we are not able to see it. Something is happening, but nothing is printed. Okay, so if you want to see that where you have used space bar, where you have used enter key and tab keys, at that time we can use this symbol. Here you can see show hide button. This is show hide button. It is like inverted P shape. Okay, so it is there in the standard toolbar. When you will click on it, what will happen? Each time when you press enter in the previous activity, writer placed a paragraph mark. Paragraph mark will be placed over there. Then when you will press the space bar, okay, wherever you have pressed space bar, there you will be able to see this dot in the document. And wherever you have pressed tab key, there you will be able to see this arrow. Got it? So this is paragraph mark, this is space mark, and this is tab mark. Got it? So if you don't want to see these symbols, then again you can click on show hide button. Got it? Then these symbols will be hidden. So observe the insertion point, that means blinking vertical bar, that means cursor at the top of the document. Its location determines where the next character typed by you will be entered into your document. Okay, here they are explaining I-beam, okay, the cursor that appears when we click on the workspace. Got it? So it will always give you the location that where the next character typed by you will be entered into your document. That means from here we have to start typing. Okay, the next character will come after that cursor. So to move the insertion point, so if you have to move it, you simply move the mouse pointer. Got it? And click at the desired new place in the text. Okay, so if you want to move that I beam or the cursor on the workspace, then what you have to do, you have to simply click the pointer wherever you want to put the text. Now the shortcut key for viewing toggling non-printing characters is Control plus F10. Got it? This is the shortcut key to use the show hide button. Got it? So here we studied about non-printing characters. What are those three non-printing characters? Space, enter key, and tab key. Got it? Space key, enter key, and tab key. And when you will press on show hide button on the standard toolbar, then what will happen? The paragraph mark will be like this, the space mark will be like this, and the tab mark will be like this. Got it? If you don't want to see it, again press the show hide button. Or you can use shortcut key also, Control F10, to see the non-printing characters or to hide the non-printing characters. Okay. Here you can see this is the show hide button. Okay, inverted P symbol. So here you can see the paragraph is changed. So this is paragraph mark. These two are paragraph mark. Here also this is paragraph mark. Okay. Then after that, you can see these are tab keys. And after every word, you can see we have to put space. So after every word, there is a dot. Okay. So now saving a document. So how to save the document? It's very simple. Document created by you exists only in computer memory. I told you when you have not saved it, it will be temporarily stored in the RAM. But if you want to store it permanently, then we can save it on the hard disk. Got it? Or we can save it on any external storage device. So to do so, we have to click on file menu again. See, this is file menu. The drop down will appear. There we can click on save or save as button. Got it? So we can click on save or save as option. Then after that, save as dialog box will display. This is save as dialog box. Here you can give the file name. Okay, type the new file name, then after that click on save button. So by default, the new document will be saved as a OO writer document with an extension .odt. Okay, what is it? It is ODF text document. Got it? ODT. Now saving a file in a specific location. If you have to save it to the specific location in a specific file or a specific folder, then to save a file in a folder other than the default folder, that is the folder that is highlighted in the save in box. So click the down arrow of the save in box to display the drop down list of the storage areas. Okay. You can see this is save in box. When you click here, this arrow, then the list of directories will open, folders, the list of folders will open, directories and folders, so you can click on it and you can choose the specific path where you have to save the document. Got it? This is save in box. This one is save in box, and here you have to click on the arrow to go to the specific folder. Okay, then click on the name of the folder or the drive in which you want to want the document to be saved. Okay, then key in name of file in file name box. Got it? Write the file name. Then after that, click on save button up to complete the process. And next time you save this file again after working on it, you are not supposed to give file name again. Got it? Once you have already saved the file, then you don't have to give that file name again and again. Okay, simply you have to save it and automatically it will be saved with the same name. Okay, it will be saved with same name only. Now, how to close the document? To close a document on which you are working, select close from the file drop down menu. Okay, here you can see the close option is also given. Here this is close option. Okay, when you click on file, the drop down will appear and here you will get the close option. So in case you have not saved the document, then what will happen? If you are working on it and you have not saved the document, then before closing, OpenOffice will always ask you that, do you want to save your changes? Then you have to click on save. If you want to save it, you can click on discard. If you simply want to quit, you don't want to save, okay? Or simply cancel if you want to stay there only, you don't want to close it. Exiting writer. So here, final step of every writer session is to exit the writer. Got it? Now what happened, once you have created the document, then you can simply close the document with close button, close option in the file menu. But the writer will not exit. Got it? Means whole software will be there. So to exit the writer, you will have to choose exit from the file drop down. Okay, in file menu itself you will get exit option. You can choose exit option to exit the writer. Got it? So any open document window is there, the writer application will disappear. Now, word processing terminologies. So here we'll study about some word processing terminology. So first of all, there is a margin. Margin means the distance from the text to the paper edge is called margin. Okay, you might have seen there is always a space between the text and the edge of the paper, and the text and the graphics are usually printed inside the margin. Got it? Text and pictures always you will be able to see inside the margin. The rulers in a word processor displays the position of the margin. Okay, you have seen there is horizontal and vertical ruler, so it will display you the position of the margin. Okay, you can decrease and increase the margin also. So this is the format you can see. Okay, this is the margin. This one is the top margin, this is left margin, this is right margin, and this is bottom margin. Okay, so we can increase and decrease the space, means the margin. And you can see this is content here, this is content. So distance between, the space between the content and the paper edge is known as margin. Okay, so there are four types of margins. You can see the distance between the text and the left edge of the paper, that is left margin. Right margin means text and the right edge of the paper. Top margin means the space between the text and the top edge of the paper. And bottom margin means this is the distance between the text and the bottom edge of the paper. So here, sometimes you need to put your text in multiple columns as newspaper. Okay, so this can be done by creating newspaper columns in the document. You might have seen there are so many columns in newspaper. Okay, two or more columns we can arrange in writer document. So the text flow within the newspaper columns flows from top to bottom, and across columns flows from bottom of one column to the top of the next. Got it? Here we can see two columns. Here there are three columns.